Hello, my friend, and welcome to my channel. Today I've got SUNone LED lamp and the UR sugar gel polishes. This is how the SUNone came. It came in a very nice box and bubble wrapped. It also came with some files. I'll show you those here in just a second. But it came all nice and protected. Let me get that box out of the way so we can open this up and check it out. There's the little instruction leaflet and the cord. Now, I love this, that the base comes off, and there's all those tiny little lights. It's got all the buttons on top. It's got 100 and 180 grit file, and then another 100, 180 grit, and then a 600, 300, I think, or 600, 800. Okay, now, if you get one of these, you're going to want to pull this blue film off, just like if you are doing stamping plates. Just peel it off, catch a loose corner, and then it magnetizes itself back on. Now, I love this little lamp. I love that the buttons are on top, and there's the little instructions. But we're going to hop on in and start using it. I'm going to start with the Model 1's base coat today. And after wiping most of it off the brush, I'm going to go in and put a very thin layer of this on my nails. Being sure to cap my tip, my free edge. And there we go. We're going to cure this for 60 seconds under the LED lamp. And here is UR Sugar's purple. I'll have all the product links or information down below for you. And then we've got a blue. And then this is the orange. And then a green. So I thought I would play with two things today. I'm going to show you how I clean off my brush. I make sure to get this polish off of the stem, and then I really do a good job wiping that polish off of one side of the brush all the way, and then on the other side I kind of scrape a little bit of it off. But I like to do very thin layers, and everyone I've talked to about gel polish that has dealings with it say that this is really the right way to do it. So, before I get off into it too bad, you can see I'm just painting. So, while I'm painting, I'm just going to talk. Super thin layers are the way you want to go. You don't want heat spikes. You want to make sure that it cures all the way through. One of the lovely things about gel polish, and here you can see I'm cleaning up as I go along. You do not want any of that gel on your skin, because if it cures, it's stuck on there pretty good. It takes a lot of work to get it off. So it's easier to clean up as you're going along. But what I was saying was the lovely thing about gel polish is it doesn't dry until you cure it. So you've got all the time you need to manipulate it, maneuver it on your nail, you know, get it just like you want it before you put your hand under the lamp and cure. That is one thing about gel polish that I love. Like, say I'm doing these nails, and I'm doing the blue one now, but I bumped the purple one. Well, it's not ruined. You just go over it again because you hadn't cured it yet. So that is one really cool thing about gel polish. One of the other things that I like about it is that they work as great bases for changing your manicure. And that's what initially got me curious about gel polish. Originally I bought a base coat, a top coat, a black, and a white, because I just wanted to paint my nails white and go in and, you know, have the base coat, a couple of coats of the white, cured, top coat cured, and be able to do nail art, whether it's stamping, water marbling, whatever. And then, you know, a day or two later, take it off with non-acetone nail polish remover, take off that stamping and the Posh top coat, and put something else right over top of that white polish again, or that black base. That's what initially got my curiosity into gel polish, because, you know, that's saving some steps right there if all you're doing is the play part of a manicure. And as you can see, I am curing these 60 seconds between layers. I'm really, really loving this SUNone lamp. I love that it's automatic. You slide your hand up under it, it comes on. I love that it has a button on it where you can change the wattage to where if you are feeling any heat spikes, you can turn it down and run it like that. Now, I did not experience any heat spikes with this lamp. None. Even using these glittery gel polishes, I didn't have not even a little bit of warm at all. Which is really surprised me, because with my older LED lamp that I have, I get them quite often. It's not uncomfortable, it's not unbearable, it's not burning me, but you can feel it. It warms up a little bit. And when I do gel polish, for every layer, I cap my tips. And if I'm planning on wearing it, I cap even the sides, not even just the end of it, but the side tips that are sticking out also. You can get longevity that way. Here I go, curing again for another 60 seconds. Now I'm having to go in for a third coat on that orange, orangey red color. It was the sheerest of all of them. The rest of them only required two coats of the color, but this orange one needed a third coat, so I'm gonna pop that on there too. Now the thing about this SUNone lamp is the price. This one was a lot cheaper than the first one I bought. The first one I bought, I think I paid close to $50 for it. This SUNone lamp is on Amazon for like $30, and I just think that's a awesome deal. So I will leave a link down below if you'd like to go check that out. I'm just sold on this lamp. I was planning on giving this one to my mother, but I think I'm going to keep this one because I do like it. I like that the buttons are on top and I'm not bumping stuff trying to reach into the back and trying to, you know, turn it on. I love that you set it and when you slide your hand under it, it comes on. And I know my mom will probably use it once a year, so she can just come over to my house and play when she wants her gel mani done. And then she can use this lamp. So there we go. And I just want to point out, remember, whenever you're playing with gels, just to always make sure you do your tidying up, your cleaning up. And by the way, I'm not using acetone for this cleanup with this brush. I'm using 91% alcohol. It works just fine for cleaning up gel polish. And I am using the Model 1's top coat today. It's pretty thick, so when you're scraping, you know, the excess off the wand, the stem and the brush, just be careful to make sure you get, you know, a good bit of it off so that you don't flood your cuticles and have to clean that up. So here we go. We're fixing to cure these rascals again and be done. And I'm going to tell you my favorite thing about gel polish. When you're done, you're done. You can go take a bath, wash your hair, whatever. They're done. So here it is. I hope you enjoyed this one. Please leave me a comment down below and let me know what you think about this review here. And that is it for today. So thanks for watching. And until next time, be good to yourself. Talk to you soon. Bye.